What years did you work at Carborundum, sir?
I started in 79. I worked through September of 83.
What was your job title at Carborundum, sir?
I was an environmental engineer.
Looking back now, do you believe you were ever exposed to asbestos?
Yes.
Where, sir?
I've searched my memory and done some research, and I believe it's Carborundum.
Going back a year ago, did you have any breathing problems?
My primary physician thought that I had asthma and prescribed asthma medication, which didn't seem to do anything. So in retrospect, and he feels the same way, that this cancer has probably been present and either not diagnosed or misdiagnosed for some time.
Why was a permanent drain put in, if you know?
Just so I could live, because I'm getting drained 3 days a week right now, between 300 and 500 milliliters of fluid 3 days a week gets drained out of me.
Tell me about the situation when you actually received the news you had mesothelioma.
Too far along for radiation or any other treatment. They recommended a double-tiered chemo to start immediately. Too far along, the lymph areas around the lung were infected with the cancer, and so the only treatment available at this stage is hopefully slow it down or stop its growth temporarily with chemotherapy.
And do you have an understanding how many stages there are of mesothelioma?
I don't think I have too many left.
Okay.
None. They also told me that if the chemo works, I could get a few years. If the chemo doesn't work, I might have a year. It's very hard to tell.
Did you have any side effects to chemotherapy yesterday?
Yes, I had chemo on Friday, and they put you on steroids, anti-nausea drugs, and then the double tier of chemo. That's all IV. Usually takes 2 days for the dexamethasone to wear off, and then all the bad stuff kicks in for the chemo. It affects all my mucous membranes, my eyes, my brain, my hearing plugs up, my nose, my throat, and last but not least, the stomach and everything connected to the stomach. And each consecutive chemo treatment, it started out, I thought I was going to get away with no problems, and I'm pretty sick right now.
And what's the purpose of the catheter again, sir?
It drains the fluid caused by the inflammation of the mesothelioma. So there's the body tries to buffer the cancer by putting fluid into the affected inflamed area. And so they drain that fluid out so I can breathe and not drown in my own lung fluid.
Do you believe you ever had a job where you were exposed to asbestos?
I've searched out other people in other places that I've worked, and nobody except Carborundum has the issue of mesothelioma cancer and asbestos come up that I can pinpoint where it would have been.
You believe, as you sit here today with mesothelioma, that you were occupationally exposed to asbestos, and if so, what was that job site?
Well, my oncologist told me that it's a long gestation period for the mesothelioma, and I believe it was Carborundum.
What type of business was Carborundum in, sir?
They were in abrasives, so they would make raw grains, they would make grinding wheels, and they made sandpaper.
Was asbestos used in any capacity in the manufacturing process at Carborundum?
The diamond wheels, the diamonds were glued to the base wheel with an asbestos bond mix. And I know that there was a wheel bonded to a backing plate in another building that they used asbestos also for the bonding cement. And I did a lot of work with the dust collectors, balancing them, adjusting the shaking, how hard they shook, how often they shook to shake the dust out into the hoppers underneath. And that there were bag problems, trying different bags. Dust collector bags are like vacuum cleaner bags, but they're much bigger. Oftentimes the bags would plug up and then you would get no dust collection and the building would fill up with dust and debris that you didn't want in the air.
What would your clothes look like after you worked with or around these dust collectors?
It went right through your clothes. It was in your underwear. It was in your socks. It was in your shoe. It was in your ears. It permeated everything.
Including your breathing zone?
Absolutely.
And what did the air look like when this manufacturing process was going on?
It was dusty. That's what the dust collectors were for. You're talking fine dust, fine pollutants, I guess you could call them, that were just floating around, clouding up the area that they were working in. There were many dust collectors on the roof of both areas, and they would plug up a lot, and I would be called to check flow, check airflow, check function of bag house, make sure there were no plugged dust collector pipes coming up through the floors. Oftentimes, because it was abrasive dust, they would wear holes in the pipes, and when the holes would wear out, then the whole building would fill up with whatever was in the pipe, because the pipes were pressurized.
Sir, during the time you believe you were exposed to asbestos at Carborundum from 1979 to 1983, were you ever aware that asbestos could cause cancer?
No.
Did there come a time when you learned that asbestos exposure could lead to asbestos cancer or mesothelioma?
In the time since then, yes.
And when you mean since then, did you learn that after you left Carborundum?
Yes. There was never any mention of any hazardous material.
If you knew asbestos could cause terminal cancer, what, if anything, would you have done differently at Carborundum?
What I've done in other jobs since then, if I thought that there was a hazardous condition, I would tell my boss, I'm not going to do that work. It's not safe for me to do the work.
And you're a lifelong non-smoker, sir?
Correct.